Wilkes for the goal kick for Rovers. Harrison turning it inside, but Eustace not able to get it clear, and the ball goes back eventually to number three, Newton, and there's a bad mistake there! My goodness me, Quinn was in on that very quickly from that bad pass back there by Newton. Quinn just pushing it on over for Phantom, and he's got the legs of Clayton, and that must be the first one! Yes, it is! There it is! Just short of 12 minutes then in the first half, and it's Ford, the inside left of Sheffield Wednesday, to put them 1-0 in the lead. Bobley didn't come up quick enough, otherwise we would have had three Rovers players, and a great effort, and it's the goal! A great effort there! And unless I'm very much mistaken, it's Byram, the inside right, that scored that from just outside the penalty area. To put Rovers back now on level terms with just 32 minutes gone in the first half. The score now, Rovers 1, Sheffield Wednesday 1. Inside getting the return ball. And that's the second goal again by Ford. Ford it is then, number 10, the inside left of Wednesday that has put them 2-1-0 in the lead.
In every tie but one for Chelsea this season. And a great save by Springer. Stanley almost scored in this one, didn't he? There's Ron Springer. Quinn followed everywhere by kick up. Now McCallion. Osgood back covering him. Eustace. Phantom, a beautiful shot. Oh, the shot of the match so far. Glorious effort by number 8, Johnny Phantom. Now tabling with the free kick for Chelsea. Osgood, a lovely one for Graham. And can Graham get up after his exertion? Yes, he can. And up for the corner kick comes Mick Mobley. Tall centre-half, limping badly, but he's still got up there. And off the line, what a lucky break for Chelsea. There's George Graham. He was so anxious to do well on the ground when he began his career in England. That was a foul by Bridges, because he could never, in his wildest dreams, Paddy Bridges could never have charged Springer shoulder to shoulder. Now, Quinn. There's Mobley. And McCallion. Hiring slog. Now. Pugh. Oh, a good ball to Quinn. Oh, as it only moved it onto the right, Smith was making ground unmarked. This is Phantom. That's a good one. Ford has scored. A goal. Ford has scored. I think it was over the line. Of greatness for Chelsea now. They've got to pick themselves out of the mud, and they hit back and go down they are, and up goes Stanley, knows that's the Graham and Osgood. Bring up there. 21. And Phantom playing the match of his life now to Mikhailov. Quinton calling for it. Here's Quint, number 11. Phantom, it's the goal, you! The goal! Anthony, left wing, and he's beating up now McQuinn. And a throw to Chelsea. Andrew Graham. How good. Goal kick. There's Peter Osgood. Edson telling everyone to calm down. As far as the Wednesday supporters are concerned, it's all over now. And here's Ford. He's got McCulloch in the middle. He's got Pugh in the middle. There's McCulloch. A goal! That is it! McCulloch has scored against his old club. Wednesday might pull something out from outside left, and they pull out the second goal. And it's all over. Sheffield Wednesday are at Wembley. They have beaten Chelsea 2-0. And the crowd going party runs triggered. Dancing around in his team, he is now achieved an ambition to get to the cup final. Dick Smokey, there he is, the fair fellow, limping on in triumph. A fantastic performance of bravery by him. A great performance by Sheffield Wednesday, and there's Tommy Duncan and his captain, Ron Harris, going off this conflict, beaten by Sheffield Wednesday, 2-0.
In English football, nothing compares with this Wembley Festival climaxing the season, the Cup Final. The superb stadium, capacity filled with 100,000 fans up for the Cup. This occasion has everything. But what of the atmosphere behind the scenes? Pathé made newsreel history by filming inside the dressing rooms before the match. These Everton men, tense, strung up, nervous, only 90 minutes away from victory or defeat. These men are so close to realizing every player's ambition, a cup winner's medal. Are they going to win? And for Le Bon, a telegram. Good luck to all. Over now to Sheffield Wednesday's dressing room. The same tension, the same big question. Will the cup be theirs? In these shots, we seem to share their feelings. Wembley nerves, the dragging seconds, and that question ticking away endlessly in their heads. Will we win? Ron Springett, an England goalkeeper, knowing he has to be on England form out there. And Wednesday's manager, Alan Brown. Has he picked the right team? He'll soon know. Another dressing room for the referee and the linesman. A few seconds and the man in charge, Jack Taylor of Wolverhampton, will join the procession onto the fateful arena. Only 4 minutes, the final became electric. Jimmy McAleog in possession. Off an Everton player, his shot found the net. Goal for Wednesday. Up to Everton now to show that players of their calibre aren't unsettled by conceding an early goal. Merseyside fans thought their idols had equalised when Alex Young netted, but he was offside. Another Everton attack might have brought a goal, but the good work by Ron Spring. Sheffield deserved their one goal lead. Try as they would, they couldn't increase it. Nor could Everton draw level. In high spirits, Wednesday continued through the dying seconds of the first half, still ahead by one goal. Soon sensed that it was going to be a tremendous second half. In brilliant form, Springett dealt with that one. For the Sheffielders, team and supporters, it was the peak of excitement when David Ford scored Wednesday's second goal. To be trailing by two goals in the second half is a most uncomfortable position in a cup final. It would have been understandable if Everton had wilted at this stage. They did exactly the opposite. From now on, they were the team inspired. Mike Trebilco beats Springett with a fine shot. Every ounce they have. there seemed to be nothing they could do about it. Victory to Everton and the Cup, presented by Princess Margaret. What more fitting now than the roar of Wembley to end this day?